modern college. So that initiative was taken by our librarian. So we first of all, we congratulate our librarian for that. She has completed this task with the team of library, and some technical part was given by the technical support team of Modern College. So we congratulate everyone for that. That was the first part. Second part, which was came in the in between, that was like during the lockdown period, university has given that they have their own institutional repository, and they said that they will be making all the material available on their institutional repository, the study material. Before that, our principal sir had an idea that if students are not coming to the college, students are not able to come to the college, so we are providing all our resources to the students through online media. So library was major concern with respect to that. So what sir has suggested is, why not library can reach to students when students are not able to join the colleges? So both of these concepts, that those taken together, and while uploading the material, there was one request from our librarian that all the staff members, they should upload their own notes in the PDF format or in the PPT format or in the e-content development format on the institutional repository. That was a very nice idea to showcase all the work done by our teachers. But I was somewhere I was worried about the thing that whenever I am going to put up something over the net and that is freely available to people, people can download that material, the first thing comes in the mind of anyone is that suppose someone is downloading that material and that material will be claimed by the downloader that the material is by that person only. So we have to avoid that. During our national conference, which computer science department had conducted last time, that was one of the sessions conducted during that national conference was based on this Creative Commons and copyright issues related to all the e-content material that we are going to create. So in continuation with that, there are certain issues in the copyright part. So what principal sir and the management had thought is, our staff members, they have started creating their own e-content and we want to give this e-content to our students. So why not protect this e-content and by the name of our staff members only, so that will not be taken away, or the credit will not be taken by someone else. So that was the main concern behind this, and so this particular workshop is organized for the same concern, that through this workshop we are going to give the demonstration how the protection or copyright can be maintained for our documents, for our e-content that we are going to create, that is called as a Creative Commons. So this librarian madam, principal sir, appealed librarian madam that can we give this particular workshop. So she has agreed to this and she has prepared a demo and this particular session. So first of all, congratulate to madam as well, and for the idea always, congratulations to principal sir, and thank you so much for this initiative that is taken. May I request principal sir please to guide on this issue and the regard so that we can start with the session actually. So principal sir.
Thank you, Dr. Anjali Sardesai. I welcome you all the teacher colleagues present in this particular meeting. Anjali madam has already briefed about the idea. I have 2-3 points to share with you. In next 3 or 4 minutes, I will do that, and then actually we can start with the presentation. See, last more than 2 months, our entire team at Modern College is busy in creating e-contents. E-contents in the form of audio lectures, video lectures, e-contents of practicals, and several things, PowerPoint presentations, several things we are trying our level best. But a thought came to my mind, the e-contents created by our colleagues, they should get due credits that these are the e-contents created by them. by Professor XYZ from Modern College. It may happen that good quality contents might get some further opportunities also on Swayam platform or MOOCs and similar things. So by that time, we people get such opportunities that our e-contents are selected by, say, for example, Educational Multimedia Research Center, EMRC, Savitribai Phule Pune University, or some other, you can say, reputed institutes. By that time, some other people should not copy these e-contents and claim that it is mine. It can create a sort of frustrating situation if somebody is claiming that it is my creation. If these are our efforts, we should get due credits forever and further opportunities if possible in future also. So I was discussing with our librarian and IQAC coordinator that can something be done. And we should congratulate our librarian that she came with a proposal that yes, any e-content, any digital document for that matter can be licensed. We get a number. We get a number which indicates that it is licensed and it gets recorded also somewhere, listed at international level. And then the procedure is easy. No application, nothing. She is going to tell you, demonstrate that it is easy and we have to help ourselves. In few minutes of time, our document get licensed, or say we can use the term registered internationally, and we get some number also, and we can claim that this is my creation and it has been licensed. So as you know, we are developing a culture where in our institute academically, where somebody has some important aspect of guidance to our colleagues, maybe for 5 minutes, maybe for 10 minutes, either we can arrange session like this or another proposal has come, we can record that guidance session of 5 or 10 minutes and officially attached to the notice signed by principal, it will reach to our groups that such and such guidance with respect to such and such important aspect is there in this following attached video. Please see that video as per your convenience. That is also a way out, or meeting like this has a better, I mean, say advantage, upper hand. Let us see in future. For example, somebody wants to share how to conduct practicals of botany using online technology. And that video of 5 minutes is prepared. You can watch later as per your convenience. Or it can be always be made available on IR, institutional repository. I was discussing with Dr. Anjali Sardesai that instead of downloading a video, simply watching the video, which costs less internet data, probably watching the video. If we can ensure that all our e-contents are available in our institutional repository and we can watch them instead of downloading, probably the internet required also will be less. So let us listen from these experts, techno-savvy colleagues of ours. I wish to congratulate our librarian, Dr. Sen Gupta, and our IQAC coordinator, Dr. Anjali Sardesai, for coming forward in organizing this particular guidance session. I congratulate them. I congratulate all the teachers who are present in this particular session. In spite of their engagements in lectures and other e-content and all that, they are there in the meeting. I wish to congratulate you all. And I wish all the best for the rest of the session. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir, for all the initiation and motivation as usual. Now, we may be, start with the session. Madam, I requested to start the session now.
Thank you very much, Sardesai Madam. Good afternoon, respected Principal Sir, and I am very much thankful to all the management members of Progressive Education Society and Principal Sir, all the respected Vice Principals and HODs and IQAC Coordinator Dr. Anjali Sardesai Madam, and all the teachers of this college. As Principal Sir and Sardesai Madam just now said that for the last 2 to 3 months, all the teachers of the college have been involved in developing e-contents and Progressive Education Society, as well as our college, has organized two faculty development programs in which Sardesai Madam, she taught us so many things in which we can develop the e-contents and how we can distribute the e-contents to our students. In that, Madam told us that how we can create the textual matters, how to create the videos and even the audio the lectures with the help of the Lexis audio editors and all. And she even taught us how to record it. But as it is always important that when we are distributing it to a larger public, we must get an attribute for it. We must get a recognition for it so that no one else copies our matter and our name goes along with it. So Creative Commons license, it is one of the best ways that is used worldwide by the teaching community people. And that's why in consultation with the respected principal sir and respected IQAC coordinator, we have organized this session, and we just hope that the deliberations that we are going to conduct today, it will be really helpful for all the teachers to include Creative Commons license, in short it is known as CC license, in the e-contents that you are going to develop. Now just as a general introduction, at the end of the session I will be showing you how we can create it. It just takes hardly a minute to create a CC license for your e-content. All the e-contents that we are going to create, even if we upload it in the institutional repository of our college, they come under the category of open educational resources. And just to introduce what is the term of open educational resources, this is one of the best definition that I have found. It is by William and Flora Foundation. OER, or open educational resources, are teaching, learning and research resources that reside in the public domain. Public domain means anyone can access it. Any public throughout the world can access it, or have been released under an intellectual property license that permits their free use and repurposing by others. Like we all know, IPR, and IPR is the big umbrella under which copyright comes. Copyright, patent, trademark, all these things are coming under the intellectual property umbrella. Under that, we can distribute our material in two ways. Either we can give it completely under public domain, in which we don't expect any sort of attribution from the person who is going to use our e-content, or the second part is repurposing by others. Repurposing by others in the sense how, with the help of using different types of Creative Commons license, people can use our e-content, but they will have to follow certain license terms. In today's session, our main motive is to show it to you all that how we can make use of different types of CC license, and the faculty member, depending on their own in the way in which you want to select CC license, you can definitely put it in your e-content. Now, the open educational resources category, it includes full courses. It includes course materials, several modules that we develop, then textbooks, the e-textbooks, as well as the textbooks that we are seeing in print, in hard copy. That also can come under open educational resources. Then the videos and all, then several softwares, everything, each and every material comes under the category of open educational resources. Now moving ahead to what is actually Creative Commons. It provides the legal and technical infrastructure essential to long-term success of OER, that is Open Educational Resources, and it makes it possible for the educational resources to be widely accessible, adaptable, interoperable, and discoverable. Like we all know that whenever we are working, and right now it is the in 21st century, whatever research work or whatever teaching we are doing, that needs a global visibility, because visibility is very much required in our own career progress. This Creative Commons license, it gives a major boost to the research visibility or the online visibility of the content, of the e-content created by us. Creative Commons, it is a global non-profit organization that enables sharing and reuse of creativity and knowledge through the provision of free legal tools. And as you can see it in the slide, that we can make use of CC license. In short, Creative Commons license is known as CC license. It can be used for website, for blog, for audio files, for video files, for offline documents, for images, for presentations. Like, we all are making use of PowerPoint presentation. This session I am going to I am conducting in way of PowerPoint presentation. So if I want, I can even give a CC license for this particular presentation, so that in case someone is going to use it, that particular person must give attribute to Modern College Shivaji Nagar. And the other one is the data sets. So moving ahead to the main concept, I would like to just give you a brief note about what is the difference between Creative Commons license and copyright. Because copyright, like this, the first logo, it is of copyright. This we all are aware that copyright in India, we are following the Copyright Act of 1957, and in 2012 amended with certain updations that was required in 21st century scenario. This copyright, it gives all the rights to the author or to the creator of the work, and no one can use it without permission from that particular creator. Like, if I am creating some work, if it is just, I will take example of my PhD thesis. My PhD thesis, it is copyrighted by US Copyright Act, and if someone wants to have any access of it, that particular person needs to take permission from me. The exact opposite one of copyright is the last logo that you are seeing on the screen, that is of public domain. It is around, you can see, and inside C is written, and there is a strike through. Okay. It means that whatever work is available in public domain, you need not give any sort of attribution. Matlab jo bhi kuch content, e-content ho, isme public domain mein jab aap apna e-content dal dete hai, tab aapko uska koi bhi sandarbh ya phir reference dene ki zarurat nahi padti hai. इसका मतलब ये है कि जिसने भी वो ई कंटेंट क्रिएट किया है, दैट पर्सन हैज गिवन यू ऑल द राइट्स कि आप उसको जैसे भी यूज करना है वैसे यूज कर सकते हैं. लेकिन कॉपीराइट में वैसा नहीं होता है. इन कॉपीराइट उस वो जो कंटेंट रहता है, उस कंटेंट पूरे लीगल राइट्स हमारे पास रहते हैं. एंड अगर किसी ने भी वो कॉपीराइट विदाउट टेकिंग आवर परमिशन या फिर हमें बिना रेफरेंस दिए, अगर वो व्यक्ति उसका इस्तेमाल करता है अपने किसी भी काम के लिए, देन वी कैन टेक दैट पर्सन टू द कोर्ट ऑफ लॉ. वी कैन सू दैट पर्सन, दैट गोज इनटू द क्रिमिनल प्रोसीजर. ओके. इन दोनों के बीच में, मतलब कॉपीराइट और पब्लिक डोमेन के बीच में आ जाता है क्रिएटिव कॉमन्स लाइसेंस. एंड क्रिएटिव कॉमन्स लाइसेंस लोगो इज सर्कल के अंदर दो सी, इट इज सी सी. वॉट इज दिस क्रिएटिव कॉमन्स लाइसेंस? बेसिकली the simple way in which you can remember the concept of CC license is, it gives a protection to the creator of the content. जैसे अगर मैंने कोई content बनाया हुआ है, मेरा कोई video है, मेरा कोई audio lecture है, मेरा कोई textbook है, कोई मैंने image, कोई photograph मैंने click किया हुआ है, या फिर anything I have conducted, but I am going to put it as an open educational resources. मुझे institutional repository में मेरा content डालना है, but in the same time I want that whosoever is going to access my content, he should give me a reference. He should give me an attribution for my work. So that can be done with the help of Creative Commons license. It means that people are free to use my document for reference, but they are bound by the Creative Commons license to give me an attribution. And there are several types of Creative Commons license, majorly six types are there that we are going to discuss. So what are in, just I will just sum up, copyright mein all rights are reserved to the author. Without taking the permission, you cannot make use of the material that is, or the content that is created or generated by the author. In public domain, author ne sare rights use karne wale ko de diye, aapko jaise use karna hai use karo. In whichever format you want to use it, you make use of it. Whereas in Creative Commons license, it creates a bridge. It gives attribution to the creator of the work, as well as it also gives the some sort of responsibilities, ya phir kuch rights user ke paas bhi rehte ki aap wo use karna hai to karo use in the way in which you want. For example, if there is a Creative Commons license wala video which I want to show it to my students, you can definitely show it to the students, but you need to give a attribution to the particular creator, whosoever has created that. So CC license, it creates a bridge between copyright and public domain, and the contents that are having CC license, it is mentioned that some rights reserved. In copyright it is written all rights reserved, like every time the users, they need to contact that particular person ki hame aapka ye cheez use karna hai, anything, any song, if you want to, if a director wants to use it in their movie, then he needs to contact the original music director or the original lyricist or the singer. But in Creative Commons license, it is like the person can use it with proper attribution. So moving ahead, there are, as I mentioned, there are six different license types, and the first one to start is with CC BY. As you can see it, there is a this is the symbol, or this is the image of CC BY. Adapt upon the material in any medium or format, so long as attribution is given to the creator. यहाँ पे ये दिया हुआ है, जैसे by, it means, for example, if we are going to upload this particular recording of today's meeting in YouTube, and if someone is going to use it, then that person is supposed to give the credit to Modern College Shivaji Nagar. He must write that who is the original creator of it. It is by Progressive Education Society's Modern College Shivaji Nagar, Pune 5. This is the most commonly used license in open educational resources. The second one is CC BY-SA. Now, what is this? It is basically, this license allows the reusers to distribute, remix, adapt, and build upon the material in any medium as long as the attribution is given to the creator. मतलब अगर मैंने क्रिएट किया है देन डेफिनेटली आई एक्सपेक्ट दैट द एट्रीब्यूशन शुड बी गिवन टू माई कॉलेज. ओके सो दिस एट्रीब्यूशन एंड अलोंग विथ यू कैन सी इन द सिंबल देर इज वन एस इट इज रिटन. नाउ व्हाट इज द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ एस ए? इट इज शेयर अलाइक. मतलब है जैसे मैंने वॉट एवर वी आर गोइंग टू पोस्ट द वीडियो द सेम वे दिस पर्सन हूसएवर इज गोइंग टू एक्सेस इट और शेयर इट दैट पर्सन विल हैव टू शेयर इट इन द सेम वे. ही कैन नॉट एडिट और डू एनी सॉर्ट ऑफ मॉडिफिकेशन इन इट. एंड ऑल्सो यू कैन सी दैट दिस लाइसेंस अलाउज फॉर कमर्शियल यूज. I am giving this anyone in the public can make use of my video, but the only thing that I want from that person is he should give me a proper attribution, he should give me a proper reference, and he is not supposed to do any sort of changes in the license. It If he is sharing it, he should share it as it is. And he can even share it for a commercial use. This is the second type of CC license. The third one is CC by NC. This NC means non-commercial. Means anyone can make use of the content that I have put on open educational resource platform with proper attribution given to me, and he should remember that he is not going to make use of this particular content for any commercial purposes. Commercial means koi bhi jahan pe bhi profit ho ya fir any फाइनेंशियल रीजंस के लिए इस पर्टिकुलर ई कंटेंट का इस्तेमाल नहीं किया जा सकता है. इट कैन बी यूज्ड ओनली फॉर एजुकेशनल पर्पसेस एंड नॉट फॉर एनी कमर्शियल पर्पसेस. दैट्स व्हाई द टर्म इज एनसी. इट मींस नॉन कमर्शियल. इट कैन बी यूज्ड ओनली फॉर एजुकेशनल पर्पसेस एंड नॉट फॉर एनी कमर्शियल पर्पसेस. नो वन कैन थिंक ऑफ अर्निंग एनी सॉर्ट ऑफ monetary gains with the help of this particular content. The fourth one is CC by NC SA. What does this license do? It allows the reusers to distribute, remix, adapt, and build upon the material in any medium or format for non-commercial purposes only. Non-commercially, you can just make it out that we are developing from developing stepwise. The first one was CC by, jisme sirf I was expecting that whosoever is going to use my e-content, he should just give a attribution to me. The second one was attribution and share alike. He cannot do any sort of adaptations to it. The third one is he can do adaptations, but he cannot expect any monetary gains from it. He should use it only for educational purposes. Now we have come to the fourth one. In the fourth one, what I expect that he must give me proper reference, proper attribution. He should not make any sort of changes in it. Also, he is not supposed to use it for any commercial purposes. He should use it only for the educational purposes. The fifth one is CC by ND. What is this ND? ND means no derivatives or adaptations of the work. What is the creator of the work going to get from this particular license? the creator is going to get a proper attribution from the third party who is going to use his e-content, and he can use it for commercial purposes also, because yahan pe NC diya nahi hua hai. It is only by an ND. By means proper reference or proper attribution, and ND means no derivatives. As you can see, it is mentioned this license allows reusers to copy and distribute the material in any medium or format in unadapted form only. Unadapted form in the sense, if it is a PowerPoint presentation, keep it in a PowerPoint presentation. जैसे ये अभी PowerPoint presentation as well as I am recording. Keep it in this format only. You cannot change the format of that. This gives the license to the creator of this particular e-content. And as it is mentioned, the license allows for commercial use. Anyone can expect, anyone can go for making use of this particular e-content for commercial usage also. But he must not make any sort of adaptations to the work. And the sixth type, it is CC by NC dash ND. Now, what does this particular license do? This license allows reusers to copy and distribute the material in any medium or format in unadapted. Since ND is written, that means that there should be no adaptations to that particular work. And also, my work should not be made use for any monetary gains, for any commercial purposes. No one can use this particular work, but the attribution must be given to the creator of the work. So these are the six major types of e-contents of the CC licenses that you can give to the contents that you are going to create. Now, this is another one, that is the public domain. Public domain, it is notified in this way. It is either having this logo as you are, which you are seeing on the screen, or it is written as CC0. It is pronounced as CC0. It is not CCO, it is CC0. It is a public dedication tool which allows the creators to give up their copyright. You can, once you put your e-content on public domain, you cannot take any sort of, you cannot expect any sort of attribution from the third party who is going to make use of your e-contents. You have put it on public domain and you are ready to give all sorts of your copyrights, your rights to the particular person whosoever wants to use it. And what does this public domain allows? It allows the reusers to redistribute, remix, adapt and build upon the material in any medium or format with no conditions. Once you put your document on public domain, you can never say that this person has made certain sort of adaptations, or this person has made use of this particular product for commercial purposes, for monetary gains, but usko mujhe credit dena chahiye tha. Nahi, agar aapne public domain mein dala hua hai, then you cannot have any sort of claim on that particular product. So in educational field now, since everything is on internet, and in this COVID-19 period, as all the people, they are throughout the world, they are trying to help each other. So in foreign countries, they are expecting that their teaching community, they are promoting public domain open education resources a lot. But it all depends to the teacher. It all depends on the teacher. Because you are the creator, you have worked a lot for creating a particular e-content. So it all depends on us whether we want to give it for public domain. and we won't have any rights for it, or whether do you want to give it for which sort of license, the 6 licenses that we showed. Now this is just a summary table. This I got from one of the websites. I've given the reference below the site. This shows, gives you a clear gist of all the 6 types of licenses, like CC BY. In CC BY, what you can do, you can copy, publish, then attribution is required, commercial use, modify and adapt, and whether you can change the license or not. Just remember one thing, if you are selecting the license of share alike, CC BY SA, share alike, that is SA, then no one can change the license. People can use your e-content, but people cannot change the type of license. That person will also have to retain this particular license. But in this particular this CC BY, CC BY ND, CC BY NC, then NC and ND, in all these 3 to 4 types of licenses, whosoever is going to make use of e-content, he can definitely change the type of license. He will have to give you a proper reference, but he can definitely change the license. For example, if I am the creator and Mr. B wants to use this particular e-content, then he can definitely change the license, and he can keep it as a non he can keep it as a non-derivative. License change karne ka unko right diya jata hai. I have kept it as SA, then that person will also have to keep it as SA. But if I have kept it as ND and maine usme kuch mention kiya hi nahi hai ki share alike wagera hai, if that person feels that nahi, I want to change the license, then he can change the license to SA. All the sorts of liberties are given in CC licenses. That's why it is very important that whenever you go through the website and for selecting a particular license for your e-content, please read the points. It hardly takes a minute to generate the license, but you have to go through the rights that you that will be kept with you, and that will that you are going to go give to the third party person. Now this is the particular website of Creative Commons or CC license. It is creativecommons.org. this is the screenshot of the home page. Now, as you can see, once you visit this homepage, you need to click over here. This is share your work. And after clicking on this share your work, this particular page will appear and you have to go to this get started. Now, I will just move to this particular, I will stop sharing it and I will just move to show you the demo, how you can make use of it. Now, this is the particular website, creativecommons.org.
The reason
I this is the particular website, and as I just showed you, शेयर योर वर्क में आपको क्लिक करना है. सो क्लिक ऑन शेयर योर वर्क. एंड आफ्टर क्लिकिंग ऑन शेयर योर वर्क, दिस इज द पेज दैट अपीयर्स. फ्रॉम हियर यू हैव टू चूज द लाइसेंस. सो क्लिक ऑन गेट स्टार्टेड. नाउ दिस इज द पेज वेयर इन वी हैव टू वर्क. Okay, here you can see license features.
Which are the number? The third danger,
na? Your chat. your choices on this panel will update the other panels on the stage. So that's why it is very important that you select or you work on this stage very carefully. Allow adaptations of your work to be shared. Now, if you want that anyone can make changes in the work, click on yes. Otherwise, click on no. Okay. Now, here I would like to request you that please keep on looking at this part also. Option that you are going to select here, the option spec that someone should, whenever someone is using my e-content, they should give me a proper attribution. But if I expect that no one should make any adaptations, then this particular logo will come. If I want that, yes, adaptations are allowed as long as others share alike, then this is the SA logo, which I just showed you during the PowerPoint presentation. This is the SA logo. Then allow commercial uses of your work. If you have allowed that, okay, anyone who is using my open educational resource content or e-content, that person can make use of this content for monetary gains, click on yes. But if you feel that no, I don't want anyone to make it used for monetary gains, click on no. Then if you click on no, see this particular symbol appears. Here you can see a dollar symbol is there. Just don't think that it is applicable only for US dollars. It is for all. Since it's developed by United States, that's why they have given it a symbol. It is dollar with a strike through. It means no one can use it for commercial benefits. So what is it? I am taking a CC license. I am registering a Creative Commons license in which I want that, okay, people can use my content. They can share my content as long as they give me a proper attribution. This is the attribution symbol. I am creating a CC license jahan pe main expect karti hu that people should give me a proper attribution. They should not make use of my e-content for any monetary gain. It should be only for educational purposes. Koi monetary gain nahi, koi commercial purposes nahi. And the license should not be changed. It should be kept as it is. If I am selecting this particular license, then whosoever is going to select or whosoever is going to use my work, he should also use the same license. Okay. So after this, just scroll down a bit and then here you can see help others attribute you. As in the beginning, Principal Sir and Sardesai Madam mentioned that whatever work we are doing, it is very important. If you are keeping it on institutional repository or anywhere, you must get a reference. So it is very important ki aap yahan pe click kijiye. What is written over here, this part is optional. Okay, it is not compulsory, it is optional. But why it is important, I will request all the teaching faculty members that please just don't scroll down this page. Agar yahan pe hai ye link diya hua, please go through it and fill up your data. What will be the benefit of this data? By filling it out, it will add a machine readable metadata to the suggested HTML. Forget technical terms, सिंपल टर्म्स में आपको ये बताती हूँ दैट अगर इफ आई अपलोड दिस पर्टिकुलर टुडे सेशन ऑन यूट्यूब ओके एंड आई हैव सिलेक्टेड द अबव लाइसेंस, ये ऊपर का जो मैंने लाइसेंस सिलेक्ट किया है दैट पीपल शुड गिव प्रॉपर एट्रीब्यूशन टू मॉडर्न कॉलेज शिवाजीनगर एंड दे आर नॉट allowed to use it for any commercial purpose and they cannot change the license. They cannot make any sort of changes in the license that I have given to this particular e-content. But in the same time, I want that if people want to give me attribution, then how they should give me attribution? And also my work should be searched under Google. Like why I'm taking the name of Google? Because it is the most commonly used search engine by anyone across the world. Filling out this particular form makes it possible for people to reach to you and to search you. Creative Commons ka ek separate search engine bhi hai. It is a Creative Commons search, and whosoever wants to search the open educational resources which are having CC license, our material will definitely get accessed in that. Google may be aa jayega, but even in CC search, this material will be there. So title of the work, if I want, then I will just give orientation program on CC license for OER developed by teachers. Okay. Then attribute work to name. What is the meaning of this attribute work? You can just click in this on this question mark, and you can get the meaning. The name of the person who should receive attribution for the work. Most often, this is the author. Okay. So here I will just give Progressive Education Society's Modern College of Arts, Science and Commerce or college name. Okay. Now, what is this third point? Attribute work to URL. The URL to which the work should be attributed, for example, the works page on the author's site. Now here what we can do, we can either give our college website address, which is moderncollegepune.edu.in, http://moderncollegepune.edu.in, or if, as just in the beginning of the session, principal sir said that in order to build up our institutional repository, our college institutional repository, we can upload all these e-contents on the IR, on the institutional repository. So institutional repository ka jo website address hai, wo hume yaha pe dal dena hai. And I will just a second. For example, like this is our college homepage and this is the institutional repository. Now if I want to upload my document over here, then I need to copy this particular address and I will paste it over here. Okay. Now the fourth one is source work URL. Now what is it? The URL of the work upon which this work is based. General terms mein agar आज का जो पूरा वॉट एवर वर्क यू हैव क्रिएटेड, इफ यू फील दैट यस दिस वर्क इज हैव आई मस्ट गिव अ एट्रीब्यूशन टू सम अदर वर्क फ्रॉम वेयर आई हैव गॉट द इंस्पिरेशन टू क्रिएट माय वर्क, देन आई शुड मेंशन द वेबसाइट एड्रेस ऑफ द पर्टिकुलर वर्क. For example, this CC license, I have learned this from one of the faculty development programs that I had attended in the month of April 2020. So if I feel that, if I want that, yes, I must give a reference to that particular faculty development program, then unka jo website address hai, wo main yahan pe dal sakti hun. Now, right now I don't have that website address, so I'm not going to mention it. And this last one is more permissions. It means a URL where a user can find information about obtaining rights that are not already permitted by the CC license. इसमें और भी अगर आपको कुछ यू आर एल है विच यू वॉन्ट टू गिव एज रेफरेंसेस, जैसे हम लोग जब आर्टिकल लिखते हैं वी कीप ऑन मेंशनिंग द रेफरेंस द सोर्सेज दैट वी हैव एक्सेस फॉर राइटिंग अ पर्टिकुलर आर्टिकल, इन द सेम वे यहाँ पे आप जितने भी यू आर एल मेंशन कर सकते हैं रिलेटेड टू द पर्टिकुलर ई कंटेंट दैट यू कैन मेंशन. जस्ट रिमेंबर वन थिंग कि ये जो तीन चीजें हैं attribute work to URL, source work URL, more permissions URL, it is not compulsory, लेकिन अगर आप डालना चाहते हैं then please do mention. Like if our college, if our management will take is going to take decision that all the e-contents of our teachers we can upload it in institutional repository, then you have to mention this particular website address of institutional repository. और कॉलेज का नाम एंड वॉट एवर इज द टॉपिक ऑफ योर पर्टिकुलर ई कंटेंट. दिस इज बिकॉज पीपल हु आर गोइंग टू एक्सेस इट, अगर वो आप इफ यू एक्सपेक्ट दैट द पर्टिकुलर पर्सन शुड एट्रीब्यूट शुड गिव रेफरेंस देन योर नेम. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ प्रिंसिपल सर लेक्चर इज देयर इट्स देन प्रिंसिपल सर कैन मेंशन हिज नेम ओवर हियर एंड देन designation and the name of the college. In this way you can fill up this particular section. Now here you can see what is the format of the work. Just click over here. As I mentioned during the PowerPoint presentation, CC license can be taken for multiple formats. Yahan pe audio hai, video, image, text, data set. Now just I think a month back principal sir had taken an example, like many of our faculty members have created e-contents. Right now I am remembering one particular audio lecture that was I think created by Dr. Rajesh Kulkarni sir, the head of the department of history department. So sir ne jo audio lecture create kiya hua hai, that audio lecture also he can create a CC license for that. In the same way video, here you can see Marathi department I have seen since I have subscribed to Vaijantiwala Sadhav madam's channel. As you know, during the modern FDP and PES FDP we all have created our YouTube channels as it was taught by Sardesai madam. So video jo Vaijantiwala Sadhav madam ne create kiya hua hai, there is some Marathi Bhasha video. So that video, for that video also madam can take a CC license. At present it is not having any license, it is just having a standard license of YouTube, but you can definitely go for taking a CC license for the particular video. And image, jo bhi koi images agar aap le rahe hain, that image can also be put under CC license. Then any textual matter, agar aapke sirf handwritten notes hai and you want that yes these handwritten notes should be distributed to the students with the help of the institutional repository, then you just take a image of that. Either you can just post the image along with the license, ya fir aap wo image ko PDF karke bhi dal sakte hain. Nahi to agar aap word file hai koi aapka, वर्ड फाइल में आप ये लाइसेंस कॉपी कर लीजिए. आई जस्ट शो यू हाउ यू कैन कॉपी इट. लाइसेंस कॉपी कर लीजिए एंड यू कैन अपलोड, यू कैन गिव इट टू अस एंड वी विल अपलोड इट टू द आईआर. नाउ फॉर एग्जांपल आई विल जस्ट हैव इट टेक्स्ट मैटर, देन दिस इज द लाइसेंस मार्क. नाउ व्हाट इज दिस लाइसेंस मार्क? देर आर थ्री टाइप्स, HTML, XMP and offline. HTML ज्यादातर अगर आपका कोई भी ऑनलाइन कंटेंट है, एनी ऑनलाइन कंटेंट जो अभी अभी फॉर्मेट मैंने बताया है, ऑडियो वीडियो एवरीथिंग और एनी टेक्सचुअल मैटर विच इज अवेलेबल इन ऑनलाइन फॉर्मेट, फॉर दैट यू नीड टू गो फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर लाइसेंस मार्क. XMP is also for that. If you click over here, you can get all the meanings. Okay. And if it is some offline document, samjhe, handwritten notes hai. Handwritten notes is offline. Ya phir koi book hai, us book ko bhi aap license dena chahte hai, other than the publisher's copyright or the author's copyright, then you can definitely go for this particular. Okay, like here it is, once I selected offline, it comes over here, non-digital works, download the license graphics. Now just to show you how it works, I will select HTML only because we are going to work for e-contents. Now here you can see it, I will just increase the size a bit. Here you can see this has come, the CC logo, jo symbol hai license ka, that has come, and my complete information has come that I had typed. And now what I am supposed to do, just look here carefully. There are two options given over here, normal icon, this is the normal icon, and एक कॉम्पैक्ट आइकॉन भी आता है इसमें. कॉम्पैक्ट आइकॉन में देर आर नो सिंबल्स, इट जस्ट शोज सी सी बी वाई एन सी एंड एस ए. सो बेटर वे वी विल गो फॉर नॉर्मल आइकॉन. एंड दिस इज द कोड, अगर आप ये कॉपी नहीं भी करना चाहते हैं, यू कैन डेफिनेटली, अगर आपका कोई वेबसाइट है, लाइक मेनी ऑफ अस हैव क्रिएटेड अवर ओन वेबसाइट आफ्टर द टू एफबीपीज, सो यू कैन जस्ट copy this particular embedding code and you can paste it in your website. So now I have created, just for example, I will show it to you. I will select it, copy it, copy हम लोग normal जैसे control C करते वैसे, and this is just a document. It's a word file actually, but I want to paste it over here. So how you can do it, you can insert it in the footer section. जैसे हम लोग normal page numbers वगैरह add करते हैं, वैसे ही you can paste it in the footer section. Now see what has happened. In all the pages, this particular license has come. See, this here you can see this particular license has come. This is just an example that I am showing you. Actually, तो ये document के साथ इसका relation नहीं है, but still just for showing the purpose how you can do it in your textual documents. The license. The logo appears over here and the information appears, the creator's name appears, this is the person or this is the institution to whom the attribution should be given, and it is licensed under Creative Commons license. Now what I can do, I can save this document in PDF format, and I will save this document in PDF format, and I can send it for institutional repository. So I will just show you how it appears. Just a second. Now see, this is my document and here you can see the license has appeared. Okay, so now what you have done, सिंपल आपका जो भी टेक्स्ट मैटर था आपने एज अ नोट्स उसको तैयार किया एंड आपने लाइसेंस लिया. द लाइसेंस टू हार्डली 1 मिनट टू क्रिएट एंड वंस समवन क्लिक्स ऑन दिस लाइसेंस, यहाँ पे आप देख रहे हैं, वंस समवन क्लिक्स ऑन दिस लाइसेंस, लाइसेंस के टर्म्स दैट पर्सन कैन सी कि ये पर्टिकुलर डॉक्यूमेंट इज प्रोटेक्टेड अंडर वॉट सॉर्ट ऑफ Creative Commons license and all the attribution details have come. I will just show you. Once I click over here, see what we can see. Agar kisi ko bhi access karna hai, then you are free to share, copy and redistribute the material in any medium or format. The person can adapt it under the following terms. What are the terms? Attribution. You must give appropriate credit and provide a link to the license, then non-commercial purposes and share alike, as I just explained you that the license cannot be changed. So in this way, this licensing can be done for any sort of material. You just have to keep on checking ki aap kaun sa option yaha se select karte hain. In that way, the license terms will keep on changing. Just I will tell you one last part and then we will stop. This particular Creative Commons, they are developing another beta version. यहाँ पे अगर आप क्लिक करोगे, it is a Creative Commons license chooser beta version website. Then what happens? Like I will just show you the example. Yes, I know which license I need. Next step, I just want कि मुझे attribution मिले. Next step, attribution details. I will just type my name over here. So now what you can see here in this part, what has happened? This work by Shantashri Sengupta is licensed under CC by 4.0. This is the beta version of the website. दोनों का सेम ही आउटपुट निकलता है. यू कैन आइदर गो फॉर द सिंपल वर्जन और यू कैन गो फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर वर्जन. ओके, सो दिस वॉज द पर्टिकुलर थिंग दैट आई वॉन्टेड टू शो यू एंड I have now stopped sharing and I hope that today's session it will be really helpful for all the teachers you all are creating e-contents, but along with creation, as sir said, that in case we go for uploading the e-contents, because we all want our contents to reach out to the students, students can access it anytime from the institution repository. And one of the most important thing that we all need to remember is CC license is totally free of cost and it takes just a minute. Aaj ka jo pura session hai, we will be sharing the recording in the groups with the permission of respected principal sir, and you can definitely contact me on WhatsApp or on mail and on the official mail ID librarian@moderncollegepune.edu.in. And in case you have any problem in getting the CC license, I will definitely help you out. इसमें कोई registration की जरूरत नहीं है, कुछ भी नहीं है, आपको कोई account भी create नहीं करना है. Just visit the website, go through the license terms that are given. Whatever license you feel that is required for your particular e-content, that you can definitely select. Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot, respected principal sir, for giving me this opportunity, and thanks a lot, respected Sardesai madam, for coming up with this idea that yes, we can definitely take a session on Creative Commons license, which will be helpful for our faculty members to distribute the e-content that they are developing. Thank you. If anyone wants to ask any doubt then or any query, then you are very much welcome.
Singhukka, madam.
Yes, sir.
I am Desai from Commerce.
Yes, sir. Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon. I have a question. Like you mentioned, it is this beta version.
Yeah.
Do we have any other regulations in the beta version? This is question number one. And question number two is, if we prepare the text and the video to be uploaded in YouTube, what are the regulations for it?
For the copyright regulations. Sir, can you just repeat?
The first one you mentioned about the beta version for CC license. Do you have any additional regulations in that?
No, sir. Nothing like that. Data version in the sense of?
You mentioned in the last part like beta, BETA.
Data sets, sir. Data sets, mein hum hi nahi jaane. Data sets is for computer people basically.
Okay.
If you are creating something, na, like most of the times we are going to upload either the PowerPoint presentation, nahi to koi video ya audio lecture hai. So audio lecture ke आप जैसे रिकॉर्डिंग करोगे आपका ऑडियो लेक्चर एट द बिगिनिंग ऑफ द ऑडियो लेक्चर यू कैन जस्ट से दैट आई एम प्रोफेसर देसाई फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कॉमर्स एंड मॉडर्न कॉलेज ऑफ आर्ट साइंस एंड कॉमर्स एंड दिस पर्टिकुलर ऑडियो लेक्चर इज अंडर सीसी लाइसेंस ऐसा आपको बोल के देन यू कैन स्टार्ट रिकॉर्डिंग योर लेक्चर इस तरीके से करना है और अगर YouTube में आप कुछ अपलोड करते हैं द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ योर क्वेश्चन यूट्यूब में जब भी हम लोग अपलोड करते रहते हैं वीडियो देयर इज एक लाइसेंस का पार्ट उसमें आता है नॉर्मली उसमें दो ऑप्शंस रहते हैं सर स्टैंडर्ड लाइसेंस ऑफ YouTube एंड द सेकेंड ऑप्शन इज CC लाइसेंस नॉर्मली बाई डिफॉल्ट वो स्टैंडर्ड लाइसेंस ऑफ YouTube ही रहता है तो अगर आपको सीसी लाइसेंस चाहिए तो आप इसमें सीसी लाइसेंस डाल सकते हैं
ओके
एंड इन द सेम वे यू कैन डू आप इसमें कॉपी पेस्ट कर लो और उस तरीके से कर सकते हैं जैसा भी दिखाया मैंने कि किस कैसे आप सीसी का लाइसेंस कॉपी कर सकते हो सो दैट वे आल्सो यू कैन डू अदरवाइज जो FDP में हमें जो सिखाया गया था दैट वी कैन मेक यूज ऑफ ओपन शॉट वीडियो एडिटर आप सिर्फ एक स्लाइड भी बना सकते हैं आई विल जस्ट वन सेकेंड शेयर द स्क्रीन वंस अगेन नाउ दिस इज वन पर्टिकुलर पेज It is very useful marking your work with a CC license. It gives you a ready reference कि आपको कौन से type of work के लिए किस तरीके से आप create कर सकते हैं. Like यहाँ पे जैसे I am just scrolling down the website, the web page. Like here you can see PowerPoint presentation. ओके पावरपॉइंट प्रेजेंटेशन में यहाँ पे जैसे दिया इन्होंने प्लीज एट्रीब्यूट क्रिएटिव कॉमन्स विद अ लिंक टू creativecommons.org वॉट एवर लाइसेंस यू आर गोइंग टू सिलेक्ट उसको आप कॉपी करके आपके पावरपॉइंट के या तो लास्ट में रख दीजिए पावरपॉइंट प्रेजेंटेशन के या उसके शुरुआत में आप इंक्लूड कर दीजिए सो दैट पर्टिकुलर लाइसेंस टर्म्स एंड कंडीशंस विल अपीयर अलोंग विद योर पावरपॉइंट प्रेजेंटेशन अदरवाइज जो लास्ट में थैंक यू का भी स्लाइड रहता है उसमें आप इसको सिर्फ कॉपी पेस्ट कर दीजिए अनदर वन इज वीडियो जैसे हमारा वीडियो है वीडियो में आप कैसे कर सकते हैं यू क्रिएट अ स्लाइड एंड विद द हेल्प ऑफ ऑल दिस ओपन शॉट वीडियो एडिटर ये स्लाइड को आप आपके वीडियो के साथ डाल के यू क्रिएट यू रेंडर द वीडियो जो जिस तरीके से हमें सिखाया गया था दैट वी कैन मेक यूज ऑफ ओपन शॉट वीडियो एडिटर So you create a slide and This slide, you can either mention it at the end of your video lecture or at the beginning of your video lecture, और उसको कंबाइन करके आप उसको यूट्यूब में अपलोड कर दो, तो जो भी कोई एक्सेस करेगा उसको ये क्लियरली समझ में आ जाएगा दैट दिस पर्टिकुलर ई कंटेंट इज प्रोटेक्टेड अंडर सम सॉर्ट ऑफ लाइसेंस. एंड देन दिस इज द ऑडियो, ऑडियो लेक्चर का अभी जैसे मैंने एक एग्जांपल दिया, अगर कोई ऑडियो लेक्चर है, ऑडियो लेक्चर के पहले आप सिर्फ आपका नाम बताओ दैट आई एम मिस्टर, आई एम डॉक्टर एक्स एक्स, एंड व्हाट इज योर डेजिग्नेशन, your name of college, and this is protected under this CC license, and then you can start the lecture. So in this way we can create different types of CC license along with the types of e-contents. Okay.
Okay, ma'am. Thank yeah. you. Okay.
Yeah, welcome, sir. If any other question is there, then please.
Hello, good afternoon, everybody. Is there any
Hello?
Yeah, it seems there are no more questions. If anybody has questions, please.
Hello, ma'am. This is Arindani here.
Yes, ma'am. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, madam. Madam, I have a question. When we look at a lot of resources on the web, suppose I want to share those resources. What are the, say, let's say it's a document or it's a presentation. Yeah, presentation, of course, you said, but if it's a document or then where do generally people prefer to put their licenses? Because probably now we will be able to locate them, but now generally where do they put that? This is protected under this license. Where do they generally have those attributes located on their document so that I can look for them?
Madam, are you talking about uploading your own document?
No. Suppose I want to download somebody else's document and share it with my students.
Okay. Madam, in case the license terms are not इंक्लूडेड इन द डॉक्यूमेंट, जैसे अभी आपने देखा होगा मैंने एक आपको डॉक्यूमेंट क्रिएट करके दिखाया, ओके, इन दैट आई हैड मेंशन दैट दिस इज प्रोटेक्टेड अंडर सीसी लाइसेंस एंड ऑल. इन केस एनीथिंग इज नॉट मेंशन देन यू कैन शेयर इट, बट इट विल बी ऑलवेज बेटर दैट वी यू गिव द एट्रीब्यूशन टू द दैट ओके आई हैव टेकन दिस डॉक्यूमेंट फ्रॉम दिस पर्टिकुलर वेबसाइट. Like you might have seen that in the PowerPoint presentation, in below every slide I have mentioned that means from which website I have referred the particular information. So you can definitely make use of the information that is available on the internet, but just remember that although the license terms are not mentioned, but it is always, since we are teachers, so we must teach our students that कैसे रेफरेंसेस देने हैं, बिकॉज इफ वी टीच देन ओनली दे विल आल्सो गिव रेफरेंसेस इन द फ्यूचर.
राइट राइट नाउ दैट वी जनरली डू, बट जनरली वेयर डू वी लुक फॉर, इट इज द प्रेफर्ड लोकेशन ऑन द डॉक्यूमेंट.
इट इज गिवन आइदर एट द बिगिनिंग ऑफ द डॉक्यूमेंट और सम पीपल दे जस्ट मेंशन इट थ्रू आउट द कंप्लीट टेक्सचुअल डॉक्यूमेंट और एट द एंड ऑफ द डॉक्यूमेंट. इन केस इट इज नॉट अपियरिंग देन इट इज नॉट अंडर सीसी लाइसेंस. It is just available on public domain, but you can definitely give the attribution as I mentioned.
Yes.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Are there any more questions on CC licensing?
Good afternoon, sir. Could I just ask a small question? I'm Dr. Sate here.
Please, please, please. Yeah.
Good afternoon, everybody. Madam Sengupta, you just mentioned in your presentation today that we can also license images. What category of images can be licensed?
There is no category, madam. Any image can be licensed.
Can photographs also be licensed?
Yes.
Say for example, it could be a plant, it
anything,
could be a micrograph.
Anything. Anything can be licensed. Anything can be licensed. Sir, just I will take last year. I will just show you one thing. Like this is the home page I am showing you of Creative Commons. Once you scroll down here, you can see all this. Like, see, this is just a hummingbird. Okay, this is available in public domain. Like just now, Satya madam, she asked that what is meant by images. This is a photo. This is available on public domain. This is also a photo, but this is licensed under CC by SA. It means share alike. I cannot change the license. And at present, Creative Commons, this part I just forgot to mention, at present, the CC license version 4.0 is going on. Okay, so whatever license we are going to generate, the 4.0 term is going to be displayed. This is another image. It is licensed by, it is licensed by Oscar Nilsson under CC by ND 3.0. So, this is, I think, Satya madam, you can definitely understand that. That's why I mentioned that you can license any image. You just take, if botany people are there, you have clicked a particular photo, you want to license it, you can do it.
Yes, so, I mean, I asked with that only because we use micrographs for sections, we use pictures for tissue culture, so can we also license that?
Yes, that madam, you can definitely license it.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you, madam, thank you.
Any more questions? Srinagupta madam?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, it seems there are no more questions. So we'll move ahead. Yeah?
Okay.
So now we are at the last part of this sort of workshop today. And since Sardesai madam is not there, and it seems that I'm the only ICSN member attending this meeting now.
Okay.
The last part, proposing the vote of thanks, is with me now. So here I propose vote of thanks. We are very grateful to our principal sir for giving us this opportunity to arrange this workshop, and we are thankful to you, madam Srinagupta madam, for delivering this very nice presentation in a very lucid and language.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Slides. Thank you very much, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you very much, sir. I am really very much thankful to the management members of Progressive Education Society, respected principal, sir, all the vice principals, IQAC coordinator, madam, and to all the respected teachers for attending the session. Please feel free to contact me in case you have any problem in generating the CC license. I'm always available on WhatsApp and on mail. So I look forward to attending to your queries in case you have any. Thanks a lot, sir.
Yes. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay. Now, since the lecture is over, people can leave the meeting room. Thank you very much.
Thank you.